Hello everyone, in this video we shall study about river ranching program, economics of animal rearing. Topic will be covered and this is important for GS paper 3. Nationwide river ranching program was recently launched in Uttar Pradesh along with Uttar Pradesh. Other four states, namely Orisha, Uttarakhand, Tripura, Chhattisgarh, also participated in the launch of nationwide river ranching program. 3 lakh fingerlings were ranched at 3 sites in UP, namely Frizghat, Tigri Mirad, Garh Mukteshwar and Bijnor. What is river ranching? River ranching is a form of aquaculture in which a population of a fish species is held in captivity for the first stage of their lives. They are then released and later harvested as adults when they return from the sea to their freshwater birthplace to spawn. River ranching program was introduced as a special activity under the Pradhan Mantri Matasya Sampada Yojana scheme to augment and enhance fish production and productivity by expanding, intensifying, diversifying and utilizing land and water productively. National Fisheries Development Board is implementing agency of this project. Hyderabad is the nodal agency under central component of PMMSY. What is the need of program? As the human population is growing, requirement of high quality protein and demand of fish is increasing gradually. Thus, to promote sustainable use and conservation of fishery resources in an economical and environmentally responsible manner, river ranching program was launched. This program will help in achieving sustainable fisheries, conserving biodiversity, accessing ecosystem services, reducing habitat degradation and maximizing social economic benefits. It will also ensure the upgradation of traditional fishery trade and social protection of inland communities and ecosystem sustainability. 20,000 crores for fishermen through PMMSY. So PMMSY is a scheme for focused and sustainable development of fisheries. 20,050 crores has been sanctioned for its implementation during a period of 5 years in all states union territories as a part of Atmanirbhar Bharat package. The scheme focuses on many fishery oriented activities in marine inland fisheries and aquaculture. It seeks to adopt cluster of area based approaches, enhance fish production by an additional 70 lakh ton by 2024-25. Increase fisheries export earning 1 lakh crore by 2024-25. Double income of fishers and farmers, reduce post-harvest losses from 25% to about 10%. Generate additional 55 lakh direct and indirect gainful employment and opportunities in this sector. Next topic is NASA's Lucy mission. This topic is about awareness in space. NASA has announced the launch of Lucy mission. It will be launched next week. The spacecraft will fly by the Earth twice in order to use the planet's gravitational pull to assist it on its journey to the asteroids. This is NASA's first mission to explore Jupiter. It is a solar powered mission. It is estimated to have a 12 years long during the course of the spacecraft will visit 8 asteroids covering distance of about 6.3 billion kilometers to deepen the understanding of young solar system. Aims of the mission. The mission is designed to understand the composition of the diverse asteroids that are a part of Trojan asteroid swarms to determine the mass and densities of the material and to look for and study the satellites and rings that may orbit the Trojan asteroids. Frozen asteroids are believed to be the remnants of the early solar system, and studying them will help scientists understand its origin and evaluation why it looks the way it does. The Trojan asteroids are believed to be formed from the same material that led to the formation of planets nearly 4 billion years ago when the solar system was formed. WHO report on terrestrial water storage loss. A report on terrestrial water storage loss 2021 State of Climate Services was released by the World Meteorological Organization. The terrestrial water storage is sum of all water on land surface and in the subsurface, that is surface water, soil moisture, snow and ice, and groundwater. Overall, terrestrial water storage dropped at a rate of 1 centimeter per year in 20 years. The biggest losses have occurred in Antarctica and Greenland. India is the topmost hotspot of TWS loss. India has recorded the highest loss in terrestrial water storage. If the loss of water storage in Antarctica and Greenland is excluded, in India, the terrestrial water storage has been lost at a rate of 3 cm per year at least. In some regions, the loss have also been 4 cm per year too. The northern part of India has experienced the maximum loss of terrestrial water. Water resources across the world are under tremendous pressure due to human and naturally induced stressors. These include population growth, urbanization, and decreasing availability of fresh water. Extreme weather events too have been responsible for the pressure on water resources realized across sectors and regions. India per capita water availability is reducing due to an increase in population. The average annual per capita water availability has been consensus.